At first, when she called me and told me I'm sick and I've been diagnosed with HIV, it was like I saw darkness.
I was saying, God, if you know that I can die of this, you know that I don't have a sister who will take care of me, I don't have anybody who is so close to me, and I know that if I'm dying of this, nobody will want me. Away with this. People came here and said, we've been living with HIV and we are struggling. And so we started supporting one another. And if we heard that somebody was sick, we could just go there, wash, cry with them, do whatever we need to do. But if we had a central place, then we can bring them there, bathe them, clean their children, have a few people who are doing the work, give them food, and maybe take them back to their homes in the evening.
Healing is not something physical, but healing is in this inside. That when your spirit is healed, then it doesn't matter what doctors say or what the condition is, you will go through.
Fear of the unknown, or fear of what would happen to you, is what is finishing people. So we wanted to remove the fear. We wanted to help people overcome self-stigma. We wanted people to change their attitude, embrace people, and just be there for one another, for them just to feel we are able, we are not just here being helped. And I see them leaving the center transformed, also wanting to give into another person's life and just make somebody's life different the way their life has been made different.
Take away.
She has really given me some courage to live. The courage that I did not have before.